include in the prediction. Remember that bioclimate is only making bounding boxes around the range of the values in the calibration data set. And then it chunks this box using, in this case, standard deviation values. You can see here that if you use a value of the default one, which is 1.960, you are including 95% of all your calibration values. Do you get it? Here you can change this option if you want. Let's include 90% of our values, so it's 1.9645. Which means that 10% of our calibration data is going to be excluded from the prediction. We are excluding the outliers, okay? And then apply. And then close this window. Now we are going to run our model. Go to the third item, the new experiment one. This is going to be, you will have this. This is because it takes from the last experiment that you use. But this is the interface in which you enter the information for running your model. First, you have to give a name to your experiment. So use here, for example, BIOCLIM. On the left hand panel, you have the options for uploading your occurrences. So go to the with the plus sign, click on that one, and go to the directory where you have stored that information, which is in the biological data directory, in the ENM in Nairobi. And by default, you will find the occurrences OMTXT file. Click on that one. And it should appear the two species, the lion and the elephant. Are you there? Yes? Sometimes happens that it doesn't read the TXT file here. And if that happens to your data, let us know, because it's like a bug in the program. So you need to delete the last line of the file to go back one space back, and then one space forth, and it's going to read this. It's a bug in the program. Well, here you have on the right, on the left hand side, the two species. Select only the line, and go here to the last icon in this left hand panel. This cross, and you will see here different options for selecting the records that you are going to use. You can indicate that they have all the records of the different species are in one file, or are in different files in the same directory right here. And here you can specify if you want to use only spatially unique records. If you didn't filter your records beforehand, like I told you yesterday, if you have duplicates, you can indicate the program to remove the duplicates, both in the geographic space and in the environmental space, which is needed. Then here, you indicate the proportion points that you will use as training, and the rest, the remaining points, will be used as testing or validating the model. So in this case, use 75% for training. And you are set in the side of the occurrences. Then on the right hand side of the panel, select the copy one of BIOCLIM, the one that you just modified. You see here that you can select all the options, all the upgrades if you want. We are not going to do that right now. But that's the advantage of a platform like this one that has several algorithms, and you do exactly the same parameterization of your data, and you run the different algorithms to see which one is working better. In this case, we are going to run on Python. Then here you select the layer set that you just created, which is called Africa Present. Here where it says model settings, layer set, Africa Present. And then here the projection settings refer to the geographic scenarios where you are going to project your model to. In this case, we only have Africa Present. So select that one. And never forget to check here the option of the geographic space. Because what happens if you don't check this box is that it's going to run the model, but it's not going to give you any map. It's only generating the ecological niche model, but not the map. So it's necessary that you click on here. Then select one of the layers, any of the layers of your data set as a template. Here. Just make sure that you're in the right directory and select any of them. You have several output formats. We are going to use the ASCII grid integer format, the ArcInfo ASCII. And then we are going to indicate the output directory where we want our results to be saved. So create a new directory in ENM Nairobi. Just create a new directory called results. Without spaces, results OM. And it asks you if you want to run your experiment, and you say yes, and it should start running the model. Depending on the capacity of your computer, seconds, like here, or it could take a bit longer, for sure. It depends on your map. When you have these green circles here, when they appear there, it means that it is done. And you will see several results here that we are not going to do now because we
presentation section tomorrow, but you can explore the results here. And you see the map right here. There you go. Why do we have two colors here? Well, three colors, blue, green, and red. What do they mean? Sorry?
Just asking what you think is the map.
To see the map, click on the green circle, on the second green circle. And go down. Yeah? But who can tell me what those colors mean? Which is the last table for that, for the line?
Yes, but what is blue, what is green, and what is
blue? Blue is not table. Then the green is a little bit table, but the red is where it's going to table the way it has to fight.
Remember the way we parameterized the BIOCLIM for running this model. Do you remember that we changed the fourth volume to include 9% of the points? So blue here is absence, green is the whole range of the data, and red is this portion that we selected to be included. Okay? Now this is only the figure. We have the actual map is stored in the output directory that you indicated. So let's go to that directory, go to the Windows Explorer. To the results of OM directory, you will see a series of subdirectories, model outputs, BIOCLIM lines, copy one of BIOCLIM, and then inside that directory you will see several files created here. You have shape files, a shape file created for your points, and this one the one with the ASC extension is your actual map, okay? The other ones are the drawings, the figures that you see in the interface.
Just to demo, can you open QGIS and pull in the shape file of the points and the grid?
Yes, I can, but that's something that they have to do.
Great, but show them.
Okay, what we're going to do is to upload these two pieces of information, the shape files, the points in the shape file, and the ASCII file into QGIS in the way we did it yesterday. Okay. So, let's open QGIS. Just upload your maps. Go to shapefile first. change the color of your of your map. Remember that we have here three values only. Zero, in this case, it codes the 90%, the 90th percentile as 50, and the whole range of species as 100. So we have only three classes. So we are going to give here three classes, keep on uniform. That's fine.